with week 186. It is going to be Vampire Dormitory episode 5. First time this anime is going to get review of the week honors. So let's get into the deep dive right now. Pace. It started with quite a shocker. Well, for me, because wow, kaya pala mala superhero pala ang lakas itong si Ren. He's a fucking vampir. Overall, the pacing was quite tense because of Ren frantically looking for Mito. Do I have complaints, guys? Nope. Because in the romance genre, you would expect these kinds of pacing, these kinds of expect episodes like this actually. Na tense ang pacing kasi naghahanapan sa isa't isa ang dalawang bida. Just go to show you. Ewan. Flow naman! First gear shift was when Ren suddenly felt the urge to bite Mito. Dito siya na-expose na dampir siya. I don't know about you guys, pero this was the gear shift that triggered the entire episode. Second gear shift was when, well, Ruka started teasing Mito. And I don't know about you guys, this was the gear shift that triggered the complication. Kung akala kasi ni Ruka na lalaki ito si Mito, and he's having mixed feelings of his own. Alam nyo guys, based on by the way this gear shift went, I would love to see the look on Ruka's face once he finds out that Mito is actually a girl. Right? But habang hindi pa niya alam, every moment like this is an awkward moment. Right? Parati may yaoi vibe to it. Final gear shift was when Ren finally comes clean. Ito nga. I don't know about you guys, pero this is the most no-brainer of all gear shifts so far in this anime. Again, guys, will it be enough for you to totally discern this particular episode of this anime with just these three gear shifts? Nope. Come on, guys. If you're a true otaku, if you're a true anime fan, if you're a true fan of the romance genre, the vampire genre, or every other genre this anime belongs to, you're not gonna watch just these three gear shifts. You will watch it from start to finish, no matter how bad or good an episode is. Because, ako, ewan ko sa inyo, basta I really want to totally understand the story of a single episode. Kaya, pagtsatsagaan kong panoorin ito mula umpisa hanggang katapusan. Plot-wise! There was a backstory sequence involving Ren. Pero, I've seen this backstory before in a previous episode. Therefore, malinis ang plot, guys! Even though it repeated a backstory sequence, malinis pa rin yung plot. Because that backstory sequence also only served as a refresher, as a way to convey to the viewer the total frame of mind Ren is in right now at that moment actually. So for emphasis lang talaga ang backstory sequence na yun. Ito nga, inulit nga itong backstory sequence na to from a previous episode. Inulit lang eh. Just to prove Ren's point at that moment, at that exact same sequence. right? So overall, we got a nice clean plot here. That backstory sequence is totally negligible. Hindi siya talaga nakasira sa overall storyline ng episode na to. So pace, flow, and plot all came together and talaga hindi mawala-wala ang yaoi vibe ng anime na to. Because up to now, Mito hasn't admitted to either Ren or Ruka that he is actually a she. So while that's not happening yet, we will always get that yaoi vibe out of this anime.